Can the Mavic Mini shoot cinematic footage? I'm sure that's a question that a lot of people have because drones can get expensive. The Mavic 2 Pro is now $1,800, whereas the Mavic Mini only costs $400. And if you're somebody on a budget, saving that money can mean a lot. And let's face it, both of these drones can fly. Both of them have a camera stabilized by a three-axis gimbal, and both of them are going to be able to get you the shot that you need. Now, obviously, the Mavic 2 Pro is going to be the better tool in almost every single shooting situation, but can the Mavic Mini get you that shot? Is the Mavic Mini enough? That's what we're going to answer today. Now, with a new drone release comes a lot of new traffic to the channel, so if you're new here, let me introduce myself. My name is Billy Kyle, and on my channel, I post drone and tech-related content. Shooting cinematic drone videos started out as a hobby of mine, and as I continued to upgrade my fleet of drones and as I got more experience, I found myself accompanying a lot of professional videographers that needed assistance shooting drone videos for weddings, real estate, short films, you name it. I bounce around between different drones that are great for different use case scenarios, with my main weapon of choice being the Inspire 2, and that's what a lot of the footage that you're seeing now was shot on. Because I'm coming from such a large platform like the Inspire 2, it's crazy for me to even say that yes, you can shoot cinematic video with the Mavic Mini, this little drone that can fit inside of my pocket. Now, would it be my first choice? Definitely not. But I'm a drone guy. That's what I do. I fly drones for fun. I fly drones here on my YouTube channel. I also fly drones for work. Chances are, if you're a videographer, you need a drone just to tie in one or two shots for your video. The Mavic Mini is gonna be able to get that done for you. You know, I never understand why people say that certain pieces of equipment can't be used cinematically based on their price and based on their size, when what really determines the quality of the video is gonna be the shooter's skill level and how he or she uses the equipment that's at his or her disposal. Based on this assumption, I think a lot of the people coming to this video aren't looking for my clarification whether or not the Mavic Mini is a good cinematic tool, but you just wanna see what the video looks like. And because of that, I'm gonna show you a sequence of clips I shot during my first golden hour shoot with the Mavic Mini. I'm really impressed with how the video came out. And also, if you want to watch it in its uncompressed form, I'm going to leave a link down in the description. You guys can go ahead, check out those video clips, look at them in their full resolution on your phone, on your iPad, or whatever device you guys may be looking at those clips on. And also, I just want to apologize that the subject is primarily of like bridges and boats. That's just because it was my first night with this drone. I really am looking forward to shooting some more. But anyway, enjoy those clips. So, what did you guys think? Pretty good, right? I was shocked when I came home and I saw these video clips on my computer up on the display, and they all came from the Mavic Mini, this small little drone. Now, I can say that while I was flying it, I was a little bit worried about getting it too far away from me because it's so small, but that fear has definitely subsided. Like, I feel really comfortable flying this drone around objects a little bit further away from me. And that's something I didn't think I'd get out of the Mavic Mini. All right, so now I want to switch gears here and end this video off with an informal discussion, with the first topic being the weak points I've found the Mavic Mini has when it comes to shooting video. And I don't mean to start off on a negative foot. It's not like I don't like the drone. I think that it shoots really good video. But the points I bring up that I guess this drone doesn't excel at, the category of the weak points, will help you determine whether or not this drone is for you. Because if it doesn't do something that you need, then you're probably going to have to look elsewhere with a more expensive drone, maybe the Mavic Air or the Mavic 2 Pro, if you want to go and spend that much money on a drone. So I think the best way to tackle this is to just put a list up on the screen of all of this drone's weak points, and then we'll address each of them one by one. Now, the first weak point is the speed. This drone is just not that fast, and speed and pacing is very important when you're shooting video. But with this drone, I found that like my maximum speed is around 27 miles an hour, where the average is more like 18 to 22 miles an hour when in sport mode. So you can shoot nice, slow cinematic video with this drone, but you can't be doing any fast paced action stuff. Like you can't really chase boats or trains. I love chasing those two, I guess, vehicles. And you guys saw, I tried to chase the train and it brutally outran me. The next point on this list is no 4K. I'm not gonna beat this up anymore. I've talked about in the past and so many people are mentioning, I wish it had 4K. Yeah, I do too. I wish it had 4K because usually when you're shooting with a drone, you're further away from the subject, so you want as much detail as possible. 2.7K is nice. I'm glad they upgraded it. It's better than being locked off at 1080p, but my phone can shoot 4K. My action cameras can shoot 4K, and I feel like this drone should be able to shoot 4K. Now, the next thing on the list is the image transmission system, right? So this is basically what allows the drone and the remote to talk together. This is what sends the information back and forth between them, and the Mavic Mini has a Wi-Fi transmission system, whereas the Mavic 2 Pro has the OcuSync 2 transmission system. So out of this drone, we'll get about 2.5 miles, and it's not really the range I'm worried about. It's more of the interference, because when you're dealing with a Wi-Fi drone, you're gonna pick up a lot of other frequencies around you. And as you're trying to frame up your shot, as you're trying to fly the drone around, you're just gonna continue to get hit with interference. It's gonna jump, therefore you could potentially ruin your shot. Now, the fourth weak point is probably the Mavic Mini's biggest detriment as a video shooting drone, and that is the lack of customization and the lack of control. It all starts out with the fact that you cannot manually set your exposure when you're shooting video. When you're shooting photos, you can change the shutter, you can change the ISO, and of course the aperture is fixed. But when you start shooting video, it sets the exposure for you automatically, and there's no way to get around that. It literally says that it is unable to be used in this shooting mode. You can change the exposure value, you can shoot at a stop over, a stop under, you can do all of that, but you can't manually change the shutter or the ISO, which is a big bummer. And from there, you also can't change the white balance, and you also can't shoot in a different color profile. Like you can't shoot in a log color profile. Now, I understand that the people that are going to be buying this drone might not care about white balance, but for somebody like me who wants to take full control of this camera and this drone, it kind of sucks. Now, I do have a little glimmer of hope. I'm on a beta version of the DJI Fly app. This drone is going to be released in about 5 days. You guys will start receiving it at home. But yeah, so I hope that they add this in the future. That's my glimmer of hope, because right now I'm on a beta version and they could be making some changes in the future. So please, DJI, let me manually set my exposure on my drone. Now let's move on to the good things, the strong points of the Mavic Mini in terms of video shooting. The first is stability. It's a small drone. It really doesn't do well against gusts of wind, but man, is that gimbal stable. I had it in some pretty high gusts of wind. I was going up and down the water, the Delaware River here in Philadelphia, and it was smooth as a rock. If that makes sense. It was just very smooth, and I was impressed with how well it handled the gusts of wind. You're never gonna be flying this drone and find, oh man, the gimbal's all shaky because it's too windy. The video footage just always looks great. Now, stemming off of the stability, the control that you have over the drone is just incredible. And it's kind of hard to explain what I mean. Honestly, you have to fly it to understand what I'm talking about. But out of all the drones I've flown, this is one of the best flying drones that I've ever seen and have ever flown. And I guess the way that I can describe that is where you want the drone to go and where you push the sticks are exactly where the drone goes to. And it doesn't fuss about it. It doesn't start pulling you to the left. It doesn't start pulling you to the right. It goes where you want it to go. It feels good doing it, and it's not all herky-jerky. I have a big complaint about the Mavic 2 Pro, and that's when I'm in sport mode. I feel like it rotates too fast, so I can't do my orbits in sport mode, but no matter what flight mode I'm in, whether I'm in the P mode, the S mode, or the C mode, which is position mode, sport mode, cinema mode, no matter what I'm in, it feels great to fly. I can get the shot that I want to, and I don't have to worry about the drone doing its own thing. It flies so well, and that's something to be said about a drone that's only $400. Now, these next 3 points on my list are pretty self-explanatory, but I figured I'd throw them in here because they do make the video shooting experience better with the Mavic Mini. The first one, portability. Duh, this drone was built on portability. It's so easy to carry around with you. It makes shooting video that much easier. The next one, long flight time. I've gotten about 22, 23 minutes of flight time when buzzing around in sport mode with this drone. They advertise 30 minutes, but usually you never hit that advertised flight time. It's a lot better than the Spark. The Spark had 16 minutes of advertised flight time. So 22 minutes, definitely a lot better. The next one is the noise of the drone, how quiet it is. It does have a little bit of like a loud whine to it, like a high pitch whine. But other than that, it's very quiet. So if you're flying in the park, you won't disturb people. Or if you're actually using it like on a gig, like shooting a real estate listing, or maybe you're shooting a wedding, you're not gonna disturb people. So those three things right there might be self-explanatory, but they definitely make the shooting experience with the Mavic Mini that much better. You know, this next one that I've got here on the list, I actually was a little bit hesitant to put it on here because I figured I'd catch a little backlash for it. The Mavic Mini is expendable. Look, it's $400, and $400 is no small sum of money, but the fact of the matter is, if you crash this drone while you're shooting video trying to get an epic shot, you're only out $400 and not thousands of dollars. So the Mavic Mini shoots great video and it's also expendable. So that just makes it an even better video shooting drone. It's cheaper to replace, cheaper to fix. Now this last one, this last point, I guess I could have added in the portability section, but it's light, 249 grams. And the main reason I'm bringing that up is because you don't have to register with the FAA. How great is that, right? You can just fly your drone for fun in the park and you don't have to deal with registering with the FAA. It just makes sense. I figured I'd throw that in there because it does make the video shooting process that much easier. All right, guys, so that pretty much wraps up this video. I hope that you enjoyed. Let me know what you think of the footage that you watched. Let me know what you think of the Mavic Mini's camera as a whole. I'm gonna be covering it from a photo standpoint in a couple of days. So today I focused on video, and in my next video, I'll focus on the photo side of things because I actually think that the Mavic Mini might be a better photo drone, but there are a couple of caveats with that and I'm gonna have to do some further testing. So if you guys want, be sure to check out the playlist in the description. That's where all of my Mavic Mini videos are listing. Also, I wanna give a big thanks to SSE Photo and Video. They're the ones that sent me the Mavic Mini early. If you want to, go ahead and check out the link down in the description to their website and to their Amazon page to pre-order your Mavic Mini. Starts shipping on the 11th. It's a fun little drone. Can't wait to continue to fly it. Let me know if you guys have any questions. And as always, I'll talk to you later. Peace.